Hi everybody, how you doing? This is Bob Bennett. This is Bob Bennett Weekly Live. I have an interesting thing that I'm going to attempt to do right here at the start. And I only thought of this 5 minutes before. Oh, I think he left. We'll see if we can't get it back on. To make a long story short, here's what's happening. I just became aware within the last 20 minutes of the fact that Iran has launched drones over Jerusalem. This is like a major deal, and I have scant details about it, but my friend Bob Probert is over in Tiberias right now on a tour with the Packing House Church in Redlands and Pastor Ed Ray, and I'm going to try to get him. I've never done an interview thing using my Ecamm software, but I'm going to give this a whirl. So hang on 1 second. And it's going to be a technical, interesting thing. Let me see if he can hear me. He's in the green room. Okay. We've probably got a little bit of a delay on video. Let me add him right here and see if that works. Hey, Bob.
Good morning. How you doing?
Oh my goodness, this is way cool. Well, folks, if you've just joined us, this is my dear friend Bob Probert. Bob is one of the pastors at the Packing House in Redlands, California. He and I have a way long history. We'll go over all that later, but we are pals, and he has been unfailingly kind and a dear friend to me forever and a day. As I mentioned at the head of signing on, I know scant. Very little about what's going on. I just know that armed drones have been sent over Jerusalem by Iran. I don't know if the attacks are localized to Jerusalem alone, but right now, as we're speaking, Bob is in Tiberias. So what are you hearing where you are? And welcome, Bob. I can't believe this is happening. This is so cool.
Well, I'm glad to be with you. We're not seeing anything here right now. We are hearing what sounds like jets, could be missiles flying over, but nothing seems to be happening. I did check downstairs at the hotel, and they said, listen, if we get word something's coming this way, we'll sound the alert. Right now, we're kind of letting everybody sleep. It's a little after 3 in the morning, and I do see lots of news on attacks. Or missiles being fired at Jerusalem and Tel Aviv.
So that, now how long are you guys due to be in country, and when are you due to come back?
We're actually supposed to head to Jerusalem tomorrow, but I'm not sure exactly what's going to go on there.
Oh my gracious.
We're due to head out Friday morning to come back to the States, but today is going to determine a lot of other things, I think, as the day goes on.
Well,
there's still stuff coming.
Somebody is commenting here that they're hearing. Now, I've not heard this. Ellen Siebold, a dear friend of this program, everybody is checking in and doing comments right now. And she said that she had heard that it would take some time for the drones to actually go from where they were launched to reach Jerusalem. So I don't know if they've gotten over the target or whether they're en route. And what Israel's, I mean, you got to figure they got countermeasures for this sort of stuff. We just don't know anything about that.
Yeah. Well, and I did see an article that said they launched in waves so that they would all coincide at the right time to reach Israel. So it depends upon if you're sending a drone, if you're sending a cruise missile, if you're sending a ballistic missile, all different timing for how fast they can get here. So...
Bob,
so far,
I've...
Nothing.
Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. We have a little bit of a delay, I think. Go ahead.
Yeah, no, just nothing so far in Tiberias. Waiting to see what's going to happen.
You know, I will confess to you briefly something that I've talked a little bit about on the live stream. I've never obviously given up hope about the return of the Lord or anything like that, but... it hasn't been quite as on the front burner as it was when I was first a believer in years ago. You know, but I got to tell you, over the last few months, I've been shaking my head and saying, you know, if there ever was going to be an end time, this certainly could be it. And now this, you know, it's one thing. I know nothing about this. You probably have forgotten more about Israel than I will ever know. But but it would seem, you know, it's understandable and almost not routine, but understandable to say, well, Gaza and the West Bank and those sorts of difficulties. But boy, it seems like once Iran gets involved, that could really be a game changer in terms of escalation and just, you know, trouble times 10.
Sure. It could be. And I really believe this would be a great time for the Lord to take his church out. That would be wonderful. But I think right now we're in Matthew 24, Luke 21. We're in those times of birth pangs. You know, yeah. There's things going on that are tough. It's going to get tougher. And I honestly think this isn't the very end because of the fact Scripture tells us Israel will stand alone. And right now they're not. We're still supporting them. UK is still supporting them. They do have other allies, even in this area. And we know that nobody else, none of the other Arab nations thus far as I know, have launched any kind of attack or anything. So
yeah.
It's just right now, we're kind of waiting to see what the response is going to be.
Yeah. Now, you said you were due to go to Jerusalem tomorrow, and it doesn't take too much forethought to think that may not happen. But when are you guys due to fly out of Tel Aviv if stuff starts happening in Tel Aviv?
Right. If stuff starts happening, we're due to fly out Friday morning, the 19th.
Uh-huh.
However, you don't know what's going on, and that's going to be a moment-by-moment update kind of thing. All Israelis have been told to shelter in place. Don't go anywhere. Don't do anything. There's no school today. There was a message that went out. Kids aren't supposed to be going to school. No sporting events. No. Don't plan any events where a bunch of people are going to be at. Just be cautious. Be very, very cautious.
I mean, this is going to sound way stupid and unsophisticated, but I have to remind myself, Sunday is Israel's Monday, right? In terms of the start
Correct.
Of the week.
Yeah, it's the first day of the week, and so everybody's back to work on the first day of the week. It is Sunday morning here.
Yeah.
Like I said, we're a little after 3. It's 3:08 in the morning here.
And did I wake you up, or were you up already?
No, lots of people from the States woke me up, sending text and notes saying, we're praying for you, how you doing, where are you at? For a while, I couldn't answer them fast enough, so.
Yeah, I had texted Alice and Rick Thompson because tomorrow night I'm playing out at Calvary Chapel Red Barn with Lee Coe. They're doing their 50th anniversary out there, and I'm going to be playing tomorrow night, so I texted her, and she's the one who tipped me off to what was going on. I had no idea.
Yeah, actually, they were the first ones to wake me up. And tell everybody Red Barn hello. Thank you
sure
for the prayer.
Will. You bet.
But, there's like there always is during situations like this, there's a lot of... what do I call it? I don't want to call it propaganda or false information, but I'd say a lot of strange communication. I heard this or I heard that, and I don't want to give any communication of something I haven't really seen or don't really know.
Right.
I know there's missiles coming. There's things on TV that are showing them being taken out, and I know that television says that Biden and Netanyahu are speaking on the phone. And all it says on the TV right now is Iran attacks Israel with dozens of drones.
Yeah.
So well, that's
Bob,
the latest update I've got.
I know you. You know me. We could spend the next hour and a half catching up, but it's 3 in the morning, and I'm gonna sign off. But before we do, I would like to shamelessly pray for you and the group there and the peace of Jerusalem.
Please.
And in fact, you know what? Let me reverse that. Would you pray? And we will also remember you in our prayer. We have prayer every a time at the end of the live stream, and we will remember you guys tonight.
Wonderful. Lord Jesus, we ask that you would continue to protect Israel. We know that you have your hand upon this land and upon these people. We also know that anything that happens, you're still in control of everything that goes on. We ask for your protection, especially for tourists. We ask for protection that they might be able to get home to their family and loved ones. We ask again for protection for the nation of Israel, that you would watch over your people. Watch over the men out in the field that are placing their lives in danger to defend this country. Father, we ask that you would continue to intervene, Lord, do miraculous things that would foil the enemy's plans. Lord, we just love you and we want to thank you that you do keep your promises. And we know that all this is according to your world, your will, your plan, and your word. Father, we do agree with that command, Psalm 122:6. We're praying for the peace of Jerusalem, realizing that's only really going to happen when the Prince of Peace returns to rule this world. And we're looking so forward to that. Father, thank you for your grace and your love and your protection. Give us wisdom now, we'd ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Bob, I love you so much, and I just am knocked out that this worked out as well as it did. Thank you so much, my friend, for chatting with us, and it's just good to see your face, and please give my love and greetings to everyone there.
I will. Of course, it's good to see you, too. This is amazing technology, and 5 years ago, we wouldn't even be able to do this, and it's kind of almost fun right now that we can talk live across the world.
Well, it's a credit to the software makers that I literally came up with this idea about 3.5 minutes before I was going to sign on, and I've never done this before. So it's a shout out to Ecamm.
Yeah, and I told you too that, you know, I've never done this live either, and I wouldn't know how to do it. And suddenly you popped up on the screen and said, you want to connect here? And it was that easy.
Very good.
Just that easy.
All right. I know you got lots of people tugging at your coat, you know, if you feel like you want to pass something along or whatever, feel free to text us. I'll assume that all is, you know, that you're safe and well, hope that, you know, I'll keep track of the progress on everybody.
Great. Thank you so much, Bob. We'll give everybody greetings here. Greetings to everybody there. Have a good time over at Red Barn.
All right,
sorry,
buddy.
I couldn't be there with you, but I'll see you soon.
God bless you, Bob. Well, that was completely amazing and unexpected. I'm sorry about the reason that I had to invoke the technology because of the insanity that's going on over in Israel right now at the hands of Iran. But I had said, if you joined us a little bit late, that was my friend Bob Probert. Bob is a pastor at the former Calvary Chapel of Redlands, now known as the Packing House. Pastor Ed Ray there, one of my favorite places to go and sing, and some of my favorite people to be with. They are currently have what I assume is a large tour over in Israel. And so I had a text exchange with Alice Thompson, wife of Rick Thompson of the Sweet Comfort Band and a longtime friend. And she is the one who texted me and said, hey, there's drones coming over Jerusalem, pray. So anyway, that was amazing. And so thank you so much, everybody, for putting up with that little bit of oddity. Let me grab my guitar here. I was not planning on that kind of a start, but hold on 1 second. This is what makes it live. You get the big panoramic view. And let me strap my guitar on here. And then I'll scroll back and say hi to a few folks. And get us started. For those of you who may be joining in a little bit late, this has been probably the most unusual opening we've ever had. But this is Bob Bennett Weekly Live. The Upper Room presents Bob Bennett Weekly Live. This is edition number 202, Upper Room number 77. I am the aforementioned Bob Bennett, the sort of the chief everything here. And we've been doing this since March of 2020, having a weekend live stream whenever we possibly can. Got a lot of comments going on here. Dave Geckler was the first through the digital door tonight. Got a lot of YouTube check-ins all in a row. Half of the famous Clock Brothers, Tom, checked in first. And very good. Hi, Joni Halpin. Thank you so much for coming and joining in again tonight. Aurelio Cortez from gloomy Chino Hills. I know it's a little blustery here in Southern California, huh? Jay Wrinkle, hi, friend. He wants a report about Nashville. We'll get to that as we go. Remind me if you think I'm going to space out and, oh gosh, what a remote possibility that is. Remind me again, Jay, and I'll... My friend Dr. Dustin Parker is checking in to say hello of a Concordia Lutheran Church, one of my favorite destinations and some of my favorite people to be with on a Sunday morning. Hey, there's the other Clock Brother, Tim from Riverside. Say hi to Jennifer. Thank you kindly. Hi, Rick Negrady. As always, a pleasure to see your name. Hi, Jen Pro. Loving it. Oh, Raining Cats and Dogs in Fresno. Well, there we go. The aforementioned Ellen McNamara Siebold. Hello to you. Vash Matrix. Giving some greetings from my YouTube as well. Oh, my goodness. This is way cool. I was just with Greg Seneff. Day before yesterday. And very good. Greg, thank you so much for checking in on here. Thank you very much. Yeah, we didn't have near a long enough conversation. You and I just need, next time I come, we need to schedule some kind of dinner. And we just need to talk each other's ears off and have fun because it's so great to hang with you. And I was reminded again of that fact over lunch. You just know so much and are such an interesting guy, and it's just a pleasure to hang out with you. Hey, Jim and Norma White from Lake Elsinore. Another name that cropped up for the first time last week back, Wesley James Claude Platt, giving a hello from Springfield, Virginia. Asking me to play We Were the Kings. Let me get my, hang on one second. Let me jot this down because once it disappears past the scroll bar, then sometimes I lose track of it, so I just have to jot it down. Hi, Ann Swanson. They're driving now. Last week they were driving to Montana, and this week they're driving from Montana. Well, there you go. Please give my greetings to Bernard. And let's see. Alrighty, hang on 1 minute. By the way, if you, throughout the evening, if you come up with anything that is not just speculation, and you can share speculation as long as you sort of say, hey, I'm just guessing here. But if any hard facts or anything comes across the wire that you think should be part of our live stream tonight regarding Israel, I am deputizing you to do that. It is the practice of this program. We don't do political stuff necessarily. We don't have hard advocacy. And don't for a second think that I don't have some pretty hard and fast opinions about things. But that's not the tenor of the program. And having said all of that, we are unashamedly very much keeping a loving eye on our brethren and on God's chosen in Israel. And so if you've got any news about that or anything that you'd like to post, I'm encouraging you to do that, and we'll scroll down and keep an eye on it. Hey, Jody Marine, just finished Wendy's. I haven't been to Wendy's forever. I need to go back. I love their chili. Wendy's chili, and you, and then those little hot sauce packets, you break open about six of those and put them in the chili. Yeah, good stuff. Hey, Ron Harrington, how you doing? Our first check-in to my awareness from my beloved Canada. Not my home country, but very much. They have kind of adopted me, I think, as a favorite son a little bit and been very kind to me. Got some great friends up in Canada. Hey, Brock and Roxana, how you doing? They're in Kansas City. 102 years old your dad is. Oh, my gracious me, Brock. Well, you got it covered in the gene department, buddy. You got a few, years to go here if everything works out the same for you. Nancy Burleson saying hi from Appleton. And let's see. Hang on a second. Let me scroll down a little bit. Karen Jill Hensley. Hello, hon. How you doing? Ken Verhecke. Hi, buddy. Always keep up with Ken on Twitter. His adventures. This guy, I want to touch the hem of his garment so I can get as busy as he is. He is out there all the time doing stuff and releasing stuff. And I just want your work ethic, Ken. That's all I can. I mean, I'm just sorry. I shamelessly am wanting to break off a piece of your work ethic. As I quoted to a friend of mine in Nashville, my dad used to say, the harder I work, the luckier I get. Helen Bougeau, hi. And our dear Katie Duck. Katie, let us know how you're feeling, sweetheart. I know you were not feeling good very much last week. And so please give us an update on how you're doing. I would very much like to know that. Let's see. Hi, Lee Bartlett and Noni Cashman. David Friedley. Very good. All right. Let me, I'll catch up here in a minute. I should play some music. Okay. David Friedley, I'm gonna be in Nebraska in just about a month now. This is gonna be way fun. Going for a retreat. Pamela Krieg, say hi. Saying hi from she and husband Bill. Darla Joe from Kansas. So I've said many times, my dad was raised in Ark City, Kansas, in the southeast corner of the state. So when I was a kid, we did a lot of turning left at Oklahoma City and going to Arkansas City, and then my aunt lived up in Wichita. So those are the places that I've been the most often when I'm in Kansas. Alrighty, I'm gonna play. It seems appropriate that I would play this song, so I will. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness veils his lovely face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. His oath is covenant, his blood I rest, support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand.
All other ground is sinking sand. When you shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then in him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand.
All right, that is On Christ the Solid Rock I Stand. Hang on just 1 minute. Let me write down a couple other requests as I go here. Let me scroll down a little bit in the comments. If you've joined us a little bit late, thank you so much for being with us. I try to greet everybody by name. If your name gets by me and disappears above the scroll bar, please pardon me for that. Also, I try to get as many song requests as I possibly can. If this is your first time here, we refer to you with a wink as a welcome newcomer. If you are not going to comment and you're in the audience and it's like, I would never do that, then you are a blessed lurker. And then if you comment, you are drafted. I'm sorry, you're drafted into the group that we call the comments community. And the wonderful people that come and visit with each other and make requests and crack me up and do all kinds of great stuff, have wonderful insights. This is like hosting a great dinner party. I get to be the host, but let me tell you, the guests make the meal. It's all about the people that are signing on and saying hello and taking part. Bill Osborne, hi, in Kentucky. Hey, Bugsy. Good to see you, buddy. We did get a prayer request, a Brewbrief 12. You might need to scroll up a little bit to catch that. His friend Denise. And so I want to call that out because we normally do all that at the end, but I want you to take note of that so that we add it to our prayer list tonight. And thank you so much for coming giving that prayer request and also being a part of us tonight. Hey, Heather Cross. Hey, Don Hecox. Okay, so Rick Negrady, this is good. Rick just posted from the New York Times. It's about 2 minutes ago, but that may be a little older because I'm behind in my comments. Rick writes, the Iranian strikes caused minor damage to an Israeli military base. Israel's chief military spokesman, Rear Admiral Daniel Hagari, said in a press briefing. Admiral Hagari did not name the base, but added that Iran had fired over 200 drones, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles, the vast majority of which, had been intercepted by Israel with some assistance from its allies. Okay, so hopefully there is minimal property damage and absolutely minimal damage to life and limb. So thank you, Rick, for that. I appreciate it. Very good. Hi, Jeanette Aragon from Colorado Springs. And, Jen Pro. She has a Jewish neighbor, and she's about to make some dinner and saying that the neighbor loves Christians for our support and love of Israel and the Jewish people. Most of us, absolutely. That's exactly right. I think if you have your theology straight, it can't be any different, but That's just an opinion. It's not a rock solid fact. It's just my opinion. All right, hang on just a second. Let me jot that down for later on. For come and see a little bit later on. I'll try to get to some of these. Hey, Rick Lochner in Brighton, Illinois. Thank you so much. Oh, wow. Okay, so apparently this was, according to David Friedley, Iran is saying that this was a limited military response to their accusation of Israeli aggression against something going on in Damascus. I don't know. Oh man, Wesley Platt is saying that One Sunday in Salem is one of his favorite albums. If you don't know about that, let me, I'll take this opportunity real quick. I know I have it here. Come on. Come on, Bennett. There we go. That is the One Sunday in Salem cover. That's was released recently with a September 2007 live recording at Calvary Chapel Salem with my friend Pastor Steve Hopkins, myself, and the late Roby Duke about 3 months before he passed away. Untimely passing, by all accounts. So this is the album that he's kindly making reference to. You can find it on all streaming services. Look up any one of our three names. You'll be able to find it. And hopefully you'll get a blessing from that. So if you'll allow me one quick moment of self-promotion. All right, Aurelio wants to hear Rick Negrady's favorite request. Can you guess what that is, everyone? Say it with me now. Jesus in Our Time is often my friend Rick's request, which I'm, man, it's a real privilege to have written a song that somebody likes to hear over and over and over and over and over again, right? If that's what happens with the best music. Countless legions of the faithful, crossing every generation, hand to shoulder in an unbroken line. Lead us to this Sabbath morning, we humbly count ourselves among them, to seek and find the face of Jesus in our time. Though an imperfect congregation, full of folly and of doubt, we presume to ask our questions, then we wrestle with their finding out. We break the bread and pass the cup, and try to bear each other up, to live the mystery of Jesus in our time. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, Jesus in our time. There are those who are among us who believe they are not worthy. We offer you the word of life. We bid you come and dine upon the mercy we have tasted and the love given so freely. Come take your place at table now with Jesus in our time. Oh, Jesus,
And as he promised, so we proclaim. He will be among us as we gather in his name, to heal the brokenhearted, to ease our troubled minds. We want to know you, to follow you, Jesus, in our time. Oh, in our time.
All right, for Aurelio Cortez, a request of Jesus in our time. Let me scroll down to the next song I'm going to play and call that up. Doing this on the fly here. I mean, of course, I'm not much more organized even when I'm organized. That's a nonsensical sentence. You can certainly tell I'm a songwriter, right? Let's see. Let me catch up with some... Yeah, Jay, you got me. It's a retreat, and I need to add it to the concerts. Sorry. Jay Wrinkle, keeping me honest, as he sometimes does. Three Virginians in the Rick Negrete house. Very cool. Hi, Rick Carr, saying hi from Memphis. Oh, wow, saw me at Toccoa Falls. Yes, that's in the early 80s. Yeah, I remember that gig. That was a college, and it was really fun. Let's see. Okay, everybody, it's time. Now I just scrolled down, so it's time to say, hi, Rena! Hi, Rena! Hi, Rena. Good to see you. If you're a newcomer and wondering what in the world is this man doing, it's a thing. I have a graphic and everything. Look, here's the graphic with the Rena warning. This was done by our dear Katie Duck. So that when I yell into my microphone and you're wearing headphones or, you know, you got a subwoofer or something like that, this is my disclaimer so that, you know, I don't get any nasty letters from your attorney or anything like that. So that's the what we call the Rena warning, but it's really a blessing when Rena shows up. How you doing, honey? Rick Carr is also asking, I will do that. I'm going to play this song first. And then I got a request for Wesley Platt for We Were the Kings. And actually, Rick Carr is referencing the same song. But I can't really play the one without the other, so I will do both of them. The Kings of Summer Street, and then also the... let me move that back here. The Kings of Summer Street, and then also We Were the Kings. And I will do that after I do this. Okay? Okay, hi, Will Butler. Let me write down that. Garden song. This is for David. Somewhere a child is crying himself to sleep. As I pray the Lord my soul to keep,
and as my last amen slowly fades away, the night shift takes over for the dying day. A short order facial reflection leers back from a spot on the grill, and the only sound that makes sense anymore is the jingle of change. Coffee and conversation, still the tune doesn't feel quite right. Like an ongoing curse, things have been getting worse ever since he started working the night. A lady paints her eyelids up golden, 'cause they reflect the neon moonlight. She waits for the man of her dreams to dance across the floor tonight. She swears there's no commitment, but you know that she's looking for one. But she settles for less, 'cause she figures it's best to do it in the name. Does it in the name of fun. La 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 la. Soon to be a famous musician, cranks out top 40 tunes in the bar, while his mind is somewhere on vacation, far away from his voice and guitar. Seeking a cheap imitation, Valentino tries vainly to score, but it's 45 on and 15 off. There's just got to be something more, says to himself. Is there really something more? Can anybody tell me? Can anybody tell me what I am living for? La 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 la. Mr. Friedley, the night shift. There we go. Let me call that back up so I've got it in front of me. I'm way behind in comments. If you wouldn't mind, let me take just a quick second and say hi to some people. Will Butler, I did write down your request. Thank you very much, as well as Jody Marines. And Jesus in Our Time, I'll do my best. Hey, Joey K, how you doing? Mr. Kralia on YouTube. Very good. Hey, oh, wonderful. This is a name that I've not seen before. The handle on YouTube is Parker Parker. California girl moved to Tennessee. Believe me, if I mean, I've got friends, family, grandkids, church, you know, you name it, I've got it. And Elena's family, most of her family are here as well.
And so I'm in California for the duration. But when I just got back from five glorious days in Nashville, and I always look longingly toward those kinds of places because it's just a different thing altogether. It just is. Just I just love the culture of the place. I love how people treat one another and the whole deal. I just do. And but we have lots of precious people here in the People's Republic of California. But well, yeah, if you are on YouTube and you can do some likes, I'd appreciate that. I don't know. I don't think I have enough views to be able to monetize anything, and that's fine. But thank you, Vash, for bringing that to the forefront. Hi, Robin Keith. Thank you so much for checking in on Facebook tonight, as is Mark Dodd, reminding us that the God of Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. Let's see. Alrighty, hang on 1 second. Let me jot that down. Anne wants to hear Psalm 149 as she's driving back from Montana. Oh my gosh, Joey! Joey, what's your spiritual equation? Okay, I'm going to jot it down. I don't know if I'll get to it, Joey, but I'll do my best. All right, I'm almost caught up here. Hey, you were name-checked yesterday, or day before yesterday, Mr. Stevenson. How you doing? I told Colomb, I said, if Kevin comes down south to behind the orange curtain for any reason, I need an immediate phone call and an immediate lunch. So hope you and Janie are doing well up in Oregon. I know you moved to be close to family, and moving is always a pain in the, you know, in the South. And and I hope you guys are doing well. So thank you for your greeting. I miss you, pal. We had a wonderful Music City Fathers retreat. It would have been more wonderful if you could have been there, but I totally get the situation. And we loved you and lovingly name-checked you in conversation. Hey, Kathy Hart. Also near Toccoa Falls in the Little Mountains of Northeast Georgia. Hey, we have somebody on, this is a new one for me on YouTube, Arizona Red TV. Very good, and greetings from everyone. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out with our little group tonight. All right, so I know, Pastor Chris Vanover. Chris, I had to come home early because I'm doing a gig tomorrow and there wasn't a concert this year. That's why you didn't hear from me. And I meant to at least call you and tell you what was going on. And I was absolutely on spin cycle. So please forgive me, my brother. You know that if I'm in Nashville on a Sunday, it's you and me, pal. And the lovely congregation at Calvary Chapel, Nashville. But this year I just had to get on the big silver bird and had to fly back yesterday. So, but I love you lots and thought about you and did everything but contact you, you know. So what else is new? Okay, I got a couple requests for We Were the Kings. From Wesley and Rick. But We Were the Kings is part two of a two-part little saga. This is part one. I killed my best friend in the yard today. He had it coming, war is hell. I said, I gotcha, and he said, no way. Then we heard my mama yell. I hate tuna, so he ate tuna. I'm more a peanut butter man. Soda slurping, the art of burping, things the girls don't understand. My baby sister, she's an alien. Comes from Uranus, I presume.
We held her off with the remote control. Then we got bored and watched cartoons. I like Porky Pig. He called me a dorky pig. And so we wrestled on the floor. Until the voice of doom called from the laundry room. You boys go take that stuff outdoors. We are the kings of everything. All we survey, everyone we meet. We are the kings of Summer Street. Nobody knows that we are famous spies. Big Brother is our enemy. He's at a summer camp for Russian guys. So we snuck up to his room to see. His secret girly files, they were wearing only smiles. Saving democracy is swell. And if he ever finds out what our mission was all about, who's he gonna tell? We are the kings of everything. All we survey, everyone we meet. We are the kings of Summer Street. No girls allowed unless we say so. Growing up stick to their own crowd, but what do they know? We'll always be blood brothers, live next door to each other, ruling the kingdom of our neighborhood. Living this royal life, well, it's pretty good. We are the kings of everything. All we survey, everyone we meet, just him and me. We are the kings of Summer Street.
All right. The kings of Summer Street. For your dining and dancing pleasure. This is an opportune time for me to let you know, although the song was not directly about my friend Dan Ruppel, some of the sentiment in the song, and especially this next one, was me imagining Dan being the other best friend, because I've had the same best friend for almost 58, 59 years, depending on who's counting. And so I wanted to run my little ticker here to let you know that next week, it's not in studio because I'm not in the studio, but in somewhere, either here or at his house, we're going to get together and do 90 minutes together, resurrect the old Mornings with Dan and Bob show, the Saturday night, 35 years later edition. And so you're going to want to tune in for that. It'd be a great amount of fun, especially if you're an Isaac Airfreight fan. Dan will be with me to answer questions. Maybe we can play a bit or two. If we can get away with that, we'll see. It might be fun to play a little bit of that action for you. So anyway, wanted to do that. Here is the bookend to We Were the Kings. Let me retune here. What? found my best friend in the yard today. Hedge clippers and a heart attack. I dropped the telephone and I said, no way. But then I caught the first plane back. Everything was smaller than I remember. The houses and the yards all pushed up together. All up and down our old street I could see the ruined castles of our royalty. Escaping prisoners, we were college bound. They'll never bring us back alive. Past the city limits without slowing down. He'd navigate and I would drive. Everything was smaller than I. I'm sorry, my eyes went over to a comment and I lost my track. Escaping prisoners, we were college bound. I'll fix this. They'll never bring us back alive. Past the city limits without slowing down. He'd navigate and I would drive. All night to Vegas, stayed out late, got up early. In a week we were rich. Dating showgirls named Shirley. Homesick and sick of home. It made no sense, 'cause there didn't seem to be much difference. You think you leave a place, but it never really goes away. It haunts you in the night and wraps around your DNA. Just when you think you won't get caught, you find it's you that can't let go. Of everything that you've been taught, there's no forgetting what you think you know. Every few years he'd make another kid, with his first and final wife. Tried a couple of times, but I never did manage to build that kind of a life. He worked in aerospace till the day he retired. I worked at every kind of job till the day I got fired. Exchanging Christmas cards and birthday calls, he climbed the ladder while I climb the walls. You think you get away so clean till the moment that you find memories stick like bubble gum under your shoe and in your mind. You can walk the whole world round your heart, but you can never find the way to where the ending meets the start. I'll never live to see a sadder day. No way. Oh, there's just no way. Was so real, I had a dream. We were both dressed as Superman on Halloween. He had a Snickers bar, he took a bite, but he did not know that it was kryptonite. Said, I gotta go now, trick or treat. Long live the King of Summer Street. Long live the King of Summer Street.
We were the kings of everything. All we'd survey, everyone we'd meet, just him and me. Of summer stream, we were the kings of summer stream, we were the kings.
By request, the kings of summer street and its companion song, We Were the Kings. So I didn't explain it very well, and I'll explain it just quickly. That song is not directly about Dan and I, but when it came to imagining these two fictional characters, Don Henry and I co-wrote the first song, and then I wrote the song We Were the Kings after I got home from Nashville, wrote that alone about the same two guys. So when it came to thinking about losing your friend, all I had to do was sub in a thought of Dan, and it, you know, it wasn't much fun to do, but it put me in the right frame of mind. It made me feel some feelings that I could then put into the song. And as a songwriter, you know, I might have done my job too well there, because I get all the time, I get folks coming to me and saying, I'm so sorry for the loss of your friend. And I kind of laugh and I say, that is so very sweet of you to say, but those two guys are fictional guys. And I'm happy to report that Dan is in great health, better than me. And we're still best friends after all these years. So one little note, if Elena ever watches this, she's going to wince big time. And this will maybe explain a little bit of the process for those of you that are interested in how you get under the hood sometimes of lyric writing. Every few years, he'd have another kid with his first and final wife. Now, I originally wrote that line with what I thought was a spectacular adjective. It was, every few years, he'd have another kid with his first and fertile wife. Now, that's funny. It implies lots of kids. It's a weird thing to say, but here's the reason I had to cut it out, is that if I say first and fertile wife, then you're going to spend the next four lines going, he said fertile, instead of listening to the rest of the lyric. So a lot of times you'll hear directors, and if this is a broken record for those of you who understand what a broken record means, this is why when you watch DVD commentaries from film directors, great film directors, they'll say, this was my favorite scene in the movie, but it's on the cutting room floor in the special features of deleted scenes because something about pacing, or we decided to restate it another way or whatever. And I think it was Arthur Quiller Couch who said that when you're writing, you have to be willing to murder your darlings, right? My language for this is, when you're writing about the sacred, nothing is sacred, which simply means that everything is always on the table. Every syllable, every sentence, and everything has to earn its keep. I've gotten down the road on songs that I've actually recorded, figured out a better way to do it, and I've changed the lyrics right then. I'm not like rewriting scripture or anything. These are songs. And so if I can make it better, I try to make it better. So first and fertile wife did not make it into the song. Elena also suggested, I forget what the original rendering was, but she's the one who suggested the wrapping around your DNA. Of your childhood and the things that you think you know get wrapped around your DNA, which was kind of an oblique way to say this becomes a part of the permanent fabric of who you are. Okay. Hey, Diana Glyer, how you doing? Please give my love to Sierra when you talk to her next, and tell her that I asked after her and said, hi, Sierra. What a doll. I saw Diana in person about two to three months ago in her living room, and Sierra was there, so it was a lot of fun. We had such a great time. Hey, Bob Donais. Donais? I always say it wrong. I always say it wrong because that's the tradition around here. It's like, pardon me while I massacre your surname, ladies and gentlemen. Very good. All right, let me look down here on the... Bob is saying hi from Chatham, Ontario, in Canada. As I now think of it, Canada, the home of Hawkins Cheesies. If you're Canadian, you'll know what I'm talking about. Hawkins cheeses are what Dorita, what cheese. They're what Cheetos want to be when they grow up. There we go. That's right. Even you have to, if you say first and fertile or first infertile, yeah, that's true. Good call, John. See? Affirming my artistic choices from Montana, Mr. John Lord, ladies and gentlemen. By the way, say hi to Phyllis, please. John's beautiful other half. And hope you're feeling better, John. I think I gathered that you had, from a post that I saw. There's no, we haven't had any movement on putting together some of the Message Fairies devotionals, but between Gracie Kerr and me doing the album and stuff, things are kind of nuts around here, so we haven't made any strides toward that yet. Dustin always calls Elena his collect writer. Because it does have that flavor. All right, Dustin, speaking of which, God love you, my friend. Please have a great day tomorrow in the Lord, and thank you for checking in, my friend. Oh, Kenny, I'm in Dadgad right now. Did not have catfish in Nashville. Not this time, but... Oh, wow, that's cool. Dave Anderson's checking in to say he can't stay, but here's the reason. He's working an Andrea Bocelli concert in Indy. Oh, man. It's intermission, but more to come. Oh, very cool. That's great. Dave, well, it knocks me out. You take time during an Andrea Bocelli intermission to check in with me, with just me. Thank you, buddy. I appreciate that. All right, hopefully he's still here. Vash Matrix wanted to hear the view from here, which I am only too happy to play. This is the title song of the 2002 album, the same name. My apartment overlooks the
railroad tracks and a city salvage yard across the way. That's where they bring all the broken things. Just like me, they can't throw anything away. Sometimes at night, I see the fading flashing lights of the barricades that used to warn the car. An earthbound astronaut, but I can connect the dots to see the constellations in those stars. Sometimes I can see what's right in front of me. I can hear what's being whispered in my ear. It's not like I planned, but from where I stand, I can see the view from here. I can see the view. There's just one little train that runs by here. Some tanker cars, the occasional follows the track, it can never look back. Me, I don't have the same excuse. Sometimes I can see what's right in front of me. I can hear what's being whispered in my ear. It's not like I planned, but from where I stand, I can see the view. From here, I can see the view. The first early morning I heard him, I thought he was a jerk. This guy who whistled through my window as he worked. But now when I hear him, I can't help but wonder why. If that guy can whistle, then why can't I? Sometimes I can see what's right in front of me. I can hear what's being whispered in my ear. It's not like I planned, but from where I stand, I can see the view from here. I can see the view. I can see the view from here. I can see
the view. All right, the view from here by request. Hey, David, David Friedley, if you get a chance to post a link, feel free to do that to the men's retreat in Nebraska. Hi, Ralph Ackley. Yes, the tune is Duke Street. It looks like John Lord took care of that. Thank you. Part of my deputized staff. A lot of times the people in the comments community know more about this stuff than I do. And let's see. So Heather Cross posts that she has 5 leftover Easter eggs. Now, are we talking leftover hard-boiled eggs or leftover Cadbury eggs? Because if they're leftover Cadbury eggs, this shows a monumental amount of self-discipline. And I congratulate you either way, of course, but I think you know where I'm going here. Let's see. Geraldine Jeanette, that's a name I haven't seen before. Thank you so much for checking in and saying hi on the comments tonight on Facebook. Ed Childers, a worship song, please. You bet. I will do so. Let me... Actually, someone asked for Psalm 149, and if you don't mind, I will play that, and I hope that that will suffice as a worship song. I'm not... I pinch hit occasionally on worship leading, and I know some songs, but I hope you don't mind, Ed, me doing this one as a response to that. It takes care of an earlier request as well. And we may be out of time here after we do this. Coming up on the end, or could maybe go into extra innings a little bit. So if I don't get to your request, I will take note of it for this week and try to do makeups next week as well. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him, that the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name, let them praise his name, let them praise his name, praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises, let them sing praises, let them sing praises unto him with the timbrel and the harp. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his peace. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name. Let them praise his name. Let them praise his name. Praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises. Let them sing praises. Let them sing praises unto him
with the timbrel and the harp, for the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. He will beautify the meek with salvation.
All right, Psalm 149, the first four verses, with a couple very, very minor word changes. Based on the King James translation. You know what? I'm not going to be able to have time to get to everything that I have written down, but I will review this list after. And if you can swing by next week, I will try to do some make good requests, or you can come back on and renew your request again. The good news is also the bad news. I get so many people who are engaged in so many song requests. That's the good news. Bad news is there's just not enough of me to go around, and we seem to run out of time, even with a solid hour and a half. So I very much appreciate it, though. Let's see. Let me see. Did I put that video up here? You know what? I'm going to play this for you because I think this is the best way. Someone asked for a song that might assist us with appointing our prayers toward Israel. Now, I keep saying this, and I just haven't done it yet. There's a new Mac in my future that may be actually this next week, now that I'm home from all my traveling and have time to switch everything over and all that. So, if I invoke this video and I leave for a second, don't go anywhere, okay? Please don't go anywhere, because I'll be right back in a minute. If this works out like I hope that it will, this is the video, a lyric video that I made to Eyes Upon the Land. And this is a song that I wrote and recorded back in 2010. But if it seems like I've gone away, don't go anywhere. Stay right where I'll be right back, okay? All right, you guys, Eyes Upon the Land.
Does not slumber and it does not sleep. Only he knows what he has planned. His word is certain with promises to keep. The Lord scans the earth back and forth for the ones who obey his command. He will not lose those who hear his voice, and he will always keep his eyes upon the land. So much trouble, so much pain, an endless supply of well-worn hate, sorrows that no man can ever number, sown into this tiny piece of real estate. But God keeps the faithful preceding me to tend this garden in the sand, who keep the Torah and tell of him, who always keeps his eyes upon the land. Now I come as a pilgrim, a Christian and a friend, to behold the dimensions of the this holy place, and to keep in my mind that what I read on the page really happened here in time and space. My heart is so alive and yet so sad, for I know where so much damage is from, how the very words of God, such great good news, can be twisted into lies they should never become. I can never repay the past, but I can extend my hand and pray the Almighty between us all will always keep his eyes upon the land, will always keep his eyes upon the land. God will always keep his eyes upon the land.
Is Eyes Upon the Land. Thought that might be appropriate for us to lead into our prayer time tonight. If you can find that on YouTube, Doreen, you can find Eyes Upon the Land on YouTube. It's also streaming on services. But we did not know at the time, okay? We did it as Batstone, Bennett, and McDougal, and what we should have done is done it as Bob Bennett, Bill Batstone, Alex McDougal, and then it didn't matter which name you call up, it would be listed among the albums, but we didn't do that. So it's under Batstone, Bennett, and McDougal, but you can also find it, Eyes Upon the Land, you can find it on YouTube and send the link that way if you're interested in passing Eyes Upon the Land on to someone. So, with that, okay, I'm going to take just a second here because Jay is persistent and he's asking, and I told him to be persistent, before we get to our time of prayer together. I did have a wonderful of 5 days in Nashville. Three of those were on retreat. I was out at a place called Deer Run in Franklin, or not Franklin, it's near Franklin, in Thompson Station, Tennessee. It's a deer run. If you're ever in that area and want to host any kind of a retreat or anything, it's a fabulous facility. I'm not a paid spokesperson, but it's really great. It's called Deer Run Retreat in Thompson Station. And we had about 30 guys. My dear friend John Colombe is, and Rob Frazier and Paul Aldrich kind of put this together along with Lyle Williams and Dan Harwell. And it's basically a bunch of musicians just getting together to bless one another with music, to talk with one another, and a real kind of a real birds of a feather thing. We didn't really have Bible studies per se, but what it is when you get together with guys like this who've been around the block a little bit, a guy will start sharing about what's going on, and you get sort of like a mini homily a lot of times in what's being shared. Not a kind of look at your watch, when is this going to end type of thing, but I'm so glad I'm here with the brothers in a safe place, and I can talk about what's really going on, and we can share with one another, and we can give encouragement to one another. So that's what it was like. I've done this, I think about previous five times or so. So this might have been the sixth time there. We also went to, on Thursday morning when the retreat broke up from the facility, we went to Insight Studios in Nashville, and an incredible studio. It's spelled INCIITE, and there's a reason for this stylization, but it's Insight Studios, and we listened to some recordings in a room that is completely tricked out and certified by Dolby as Dolby Atmos. This is a thing that is used in movie theaters and is now making its way into audio recording. And we listened to some music that was done in this Dolby Atmos, and I'm telling you, it's just stunning. It's breathtaking what we heard, and things that we heard in familiar music that we've been listening to for literally 5 decades. I heard stuff in the mix that I had never heard before. So it was really great. By the way, behind me, I must say, you can see just out of the frame is my beautiful dog, Kirby, making a guest appearance. There he is, the cutest dog in town. He usually doesn't come in and hang with me during these live streams, and he doesn't really know that he's not really on camera now, but he's hanging here in the room with me. So, alrighty, that's Nashville in a nutshell. Had a great time. I wish I could have stayed longer, but duty calls. And so glad to be back here with you. So we'll hit the big clutch pedal, and now we'll have a brief closing time of prayer that we do around here. And then we will end with the Lorica. Since October 7th, and of course, especially now today again, we read Psalm 122. I rejoiced when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of Adonai." Our feet are standing in your gates, Jerusalem. Jerusalem built as a city joined together. There the tribes go up, the tribes of Adonai, as a testimony to Israel, to praise the name of Adonai. For there thrones for judgment are set up, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those who love you be at peace. May there be shalom within your walls, quietness within your palaces. For the sake of my brothers and friends, I now say shalom be within you. For the sake of the house of Adonai our God, I will seek your good. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this time to gather together as we do each week. Thank you for this wonderful group of people who join me and make me feel like I'm not just sitting in front of a computer with a little green light on. Thank you for the interaction back and forth, not only with me, but also with each other. And just the camaraderie, the friendship, the shared faith, the good humor, all of those things are part of the mix. And Lord, we thank you for that. We thank you that we can do this. We ask that you would bless the people of the different platforms that we use on YouTube and Facebook. And even though those companies are not Christian enterprises, Lord, we thank you for them and ask that you would find a way to against all odds, to guide them and be with them and reward them for these access to these things that allow us to do what we're doing right now. We ask that you would bless those people who are involved. We ask every week, we pray for the medical profession. The older we get, the more that seems like a relevant prayer. We pray for doctors, nurses, admin, those who are on staff in hospitals, doctor's offices, palliative care situations, assisted living, urgent care, home care, whatever the case may be. Lord, we thank you for those who practice medicine, those who do their utmost to help us get well. And we thank you that at those times that we do get well, that we are fearfully and wonderfully made, and that we're able to be well. We pray for those tonight who are dealing with sickness, those who are dealing with friends and loved ones who are in dire straits, also those who may be looking at end-of-life situations or those who have lost friends and relatives this week. Be especially close to them at this time, Lord, we pray. We pray each week for police departments, fire departments, emergency medical technicians. We pray each week for all of those in uniform, the Air Force Reserve, Army and Army Reserve, Army National Guard, Coast Guard and Coast Guard Reserve, Marine Corps and Marine Corps Reserve, Navy and Navy Reserve, and the Space Force. All of those who put on a uniform to serve their country, and by that, meaning to serve us, the citizenry of the United States. We thank you for them and ask that you would keep them safe in their work. O Lord, support us all the day long, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over and our work is done. And then in thy mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Amen. And now, please join me as we do each week, as we have been taught. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The thought occurred to me, and this may not be accurate, so don't take this to the theological bank. But I was thinking the other day, a lot of times when you're going to recite the Lord's Prayer, the thought crosses your mind, is it going to be trespasses or is it going to be debts? Well, I think there's a subtle difference between the two. A debt is something that you owe, and a trespass is something that you commit. But both of those aspects are true when we're asking for forgiveness. And so whichever one you invoke, I think you're right. I bind unto myself today gift to call on the Trinity, the saving faith where I can say, come three in one, oh one in three. Be above me as high as the noonday sun, be below me the rock I set my feet upon, be beside me the wind on my left and right, be behind me, circle me with your truth and light. I bind unto myself today the love of angels and seraphim, the prayers and prophecies of saints, the words and deeds of righteous men. Be above me as high as the noonday sun, be below me the rock I set my feet upon, be beside me the wind on my left and right, be behind me, circle me with your truth and light. La da 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 da, la da 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 da. God's ear to hear me, God's hand to guide me, God's might to uphold me, God's shield to hide me, against all powers deceiving, against my own unbelieving, whether near or far. I bind unto myself today hope to rise from the dust of earth, the songs of nature giving praise, the Father, Spirit, living Word. Be above me as high as the noonday sun, be below me the rock I set my feet upon, be beside me the wind on my left and our right, be behind me, circle me with your truth and light. La da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da. I bind unto myself today the gift to call on the Trinity. All right. Hey, I just noticed an amen from George Grant. Is that the George Grant that I know? If so, contact me. I want to send you something. It's been way too long since we've had connection. If this is George Grant, as in George Grant, and I think you know who I mean, give me a shout. I'll post my my email address down in here. Hold on. Bob. And, Hang on just a second. Let me put my glasses back on. My eyes are kind of giving me fits today. Ba-ba-da. There we go. Yeah, George, give me a pop. Give me a shot if that's you, or even if it's not you. Reminding you that if you sign up for my email list, I generally only send out an email once a week. Sometimes I'll put some extraneous goodies and stuff in it to say hi. Most of the time I'm sending out dedicated links for the live stream so I can make it extremely easy. All you have to do is keep that email on hand. And when it's time to click into the live stream, whether on Facebook or on YouTube, you have that in front of you. So let me do a couple quick things here. Let me thank those of you who have so graciously and consistently thrown a little something in the digital tip jar. I'm reminding you that Elena and I are so appreciative of that. This show has no salary, no sponsors, no advertising, no any of that kind of stuff. Whatever you guys decide to do, that's the deal. And so we really, really appreciate it, and thank you so much. Whatever that amount is, we're just grateful. And if for some reason you're not situated to do that, I really would not. Now listen to me here. Don't think a thing about it. Don't ever worry one split second about it. Just maybe toss up a prayer for me when you think about it. Listen to a little bit of my music. Tell somebody about the live stream. There's plenty of stuff you can do that doesn't involve one thin dime. And but thank you for those of you who go by the digital tip jar. We really appreciate it. I want to thank Ron and Kathy Strand. They are the co-founders of The Upper Room Presents. As always, remembering my pals, Marisa Personius, Tony Medeiros, Tom Michelon, Eric Hansen. Also, I just saw him today. I went to the shop and had a little repair done on my guitar. Kevin Ryan, Kevin and Barb Ryan are the proprietors of Ryan Guitars. See that R on the headstock? That's because I play a Ryan guitar. If you're a guitar geek, you're going to want to check out RyanGuitarsPlural.com, RyanGuitars.com. My thanks to the Message Fairy, my lovely bride, who is always behind the scenes with me when I'm not busy being live stream Bob. She puts up with all the nonsense the other hours of the days and week and month and years and decades. And she has a tough job being Mrs. Bob Bennett, and she acquits herself admirably every day. Let me also give a shout out to my brother Tim and his wife Marla, as well as Evie and my dear brother Michael. I always now give a shout out to my brother Michael, who taught me how to play guitar. He's the reason I have a guitar in my hands. He's the reason that music has been a part of my life for my entire adult life. And so I wanted you to know that, and I wanted to give him the credit where credit is due, my brother Michael Bennett, who lives in Missoula, Montana. Still teaches, too. He still has the teaching bug. He's really good at it. All right, everybody. I believe that is it. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Keep Israel and the innocents on whatever side they might be on. Keep them in your prayers, and that God would intervene and that cooler heads would prevail at some point here with this stuff. And if I've forgotten anything, please forgive me. There's some requests that I didn't get to and names that I didn't call out. But kindly pardon me for that, and I'll run over the show and the comments and so forth at the end and make up a make good list. Hey, Doug Damaris saying hi. Hi, buddy. I did get your emails, and I'll get back to you. I've been gone on retreat. And I've got a photo for you, and I will take a look at your other email about a composition that I think you sent me. So, love it. All right, everybody, that's it. God bless you. And as I am fond of saying a lot, praises be to the healer of my life. What? What, you're still here? It's all over now. We're done. Go get some dinner. Go get a snack. Watch a movie. I'm all done now. All right. Love you guys very much. You take care. God willing, see you next week, Saturday, with my special guest, Dan Ruppel.